and gentlemen, on my right, Erik Bang, the Netherlands. On my left, Lin Yu Xin, Chinese Taipei. Erik Bang to serve, level play.
Welcome back. Third match of the semi-finals, men's singles.
Third over,
one. I'm Mark Field for Badminton Europe. And I've twisted Linda's arm to stay with me for this men's singles. So, Linda, you're very welcome back again. And we've got in black for the Netherlands, top seed, Pan, against the Chinese Taipei qualifier, Lin Hsien.
Two left.
And this young Taipei man has been really explosive this week. Against Eric, who is Eric? Just laid back and. Very relaxed, takes it all in his stride. Eric is top seed, as expected, come through relatively easy. Had a tough first round game against another Chinese Taipei shuttler, came through in three games, so a good exercise, a good test that for Eric. Indeed, Lucas Clairvaux is France easily in two, and then defeated young Dane Kim Brown 11-6 in the earlier quarterfinal. Yeah, he looks to be really in top shape. This seems to be his time of year in 2 months because he, you know, his big focus will be the Dutch Open. And he always performs well there. Yeah. And Lin has been equally as impressive. Toughest game was against Luka. Taken to three, but controlled the third game. No.
4-2.
A good tempo for the start of this game. Explosive power.
6-2.
And McMahon is only ranked 280 in the world. Big gulf in ranking. Eric is 29. Unusual for Eric, really.
Set over. 3-7.
This is Lin's first visit to Europe.
9-3.
Played all his tournaments in Asia, so good European experience for the man from Chinese Taipei. Eric. Eric has been everywhere. One of the veterans of men's singles player discipline now in Europe. One of the older men.
4-9.
Eric is that type of guy who just has to keep playing tournaments. Very much like Adam Skolina from Poland. You know, they can only keep their sharpness by playing tournaments. You never see them taking breaks or a rest unless it's true injury. And he's been very fortunate also, Eric, with literally no injury. Yeah. Still has the speed coming forward. Oh.
7-10.
You know, and Eric is so laid back that no matter who he plays against, it doesn't upset him or change his attitude or change his mentality. He just comes out and plays as he always plays, which is mentally very strong. Mr. Clappy is on the master, coaching him for every good shot. Oh, backhand smash. Yeah. You love to see shots like that. He got in the jump. Two-point lead for the Chinese Taipei. Good opening to this game, Linda. Lin got a nice 10-4 lead, leading by 6. A good comeback. I think Eric will be quite happy to be only 2 behind at the interval after trailing 10-4.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds.
And certainly with that backhand smash, that was the shot of the first half of this game. Yeah. That was missed time.
12-9.
Yeah. You could tell by the sound it did not come off the center of the racket.
Over 10-12. 11, 12.
Oh, oh, good awareness, good concentration from Pan.
Oh. Third over, 13, 11.
This is a small guy here, packs a really powerful smash. And likes to smash at every opportunity. No. It worked the second time. Yeah. Oh, just out. And then nearly falling over the circle.
14.
Yeah, he seems to have the right tactic against Lin. On the other court, Pagano taking a 6-1 lead. The defending champion, of course, Andre. Beat Beast Liberties here last year in the final. So 1 point, the advantage for Lin. Oh, the shot just catching the top of the tape.
14.
Yeah, and Eric looks for the heavens at the opportunity.
15. 17.
Yeah, the smash across the body of his opponent at the hip, very difficult to defend.
It's not
all power. He has the shots also at the net. The attack set up by the beautiful net spin. Super angle out wide. Great rally, as you said, Linda. But again, you're right. When he's patient in his play, he can win these rallies. Little break and play.
Yeah.
And then Eric was forced to almost try the impossible. Bring that shuttle back cross court at the net. Yeah, you know their choice. So 19-0. Oh, nearly.
20, game point, 19.
Oh. really put that shuttle onto the racket head of his opponent. Lovely height, only half court, bang. Yeah. Another game point for Lin. Something tells me we could be in for a long match. Amazing rally. I thought Eric had it at one point, defended so well, but then a killer of a cross net for the winner. Super way to win a point. Once again, takes Lin to game point, 23-22. Just out. The chocolate is really so good for Eric in this game. Nice first court to the backhand side. Just out. First game to Lin, 24-22, but a good game. Exactly, as you said many times in the game, when he tried to finish the rally quickly, he ended up losing the point. A little bit more patience. The longer rallies, Eric ended up winning. So, interesting to see what he does in this second game. The adjoining court in the museum, Pejono leading 17-13 against Joachim Persson. Persson beat the birthday boy Henry Huskainen earlier in the quarterfinal. Two Europeans against two Asians, although Andre based in Europe. Change of shirt this time for Lin. Coming out, back out in orange and white.
Start one, 20 seconds.
More like the Netherlands.
Start one, 20 seconds.
Lin wearing these new shirts from this new Asian company. And this one is quite tame compared to some of them they've been wearing during the week with skeletons and skulls and everything on them. Longer rally, and Eric comes out on top.
Third over, 1-0.
Oh, just out.
5-1.
Great defense from Eric midway through that rally. Then you give away like 3 points like that after all the hard work. Yeah, oh gas, yeah, maybe just starting to run on empty after 7 matches this week. is found across net.
Serves over. 3-8.
Yeah, Lin just seems to have run out of ideas in the early part of this game. Yeah, it takes a lot of energy to keep that up. And the weak right arm, this is, you know, that has been so powerful for him in the first game. And that was a weak shot. Again, six match from Eric Pang. Very effective. And that's out, a long way out.
11-3, end of all.
Good lead for Eric. 11-3. Came out in the second game. Really focused. But as you say, I think Lin running out of energy. It's so difficult to come through, no matter who you are, no matter how fit you are, to come through three matches in qualification and then come into the main draw. It takes so much. Yeah. Yeah.
First one, 20 seconds.
Yes. Not only physically, but mentally to get yourself going again for another tournament, because that's what it is. He's actually starting to lift the two of them now and let him smash because he's making so many mistakes. Yeah. Ah, super.
13-3.
Of course, it also gets to the point in a game like this where the guy who's losing will just almost let it go and try and save something for the fighting game.
14-3.
A little bit lazy from Eric. Yes.
17-4.
No, he's not trying. He didn't even go, but I think he knew that lift could have been in, but he did not waste any energy.
Serves over. 5-17.
Now, while these games may be gone from the guys behind, I always think it's still a good idea to try and get a few points on your serve towards the end of the game for confidence. Yeah. what will happen now also is 19. Eric won't be reaching and stretching for the one that he doesn't think he can get, because he knows he practically has this game won. So you'll see, guys, both of them letting shots go, letting points go. 26 game point. Bit of a dull game compared to the first one. Having a little bit of yeah. Oh, drink. Both players have lost concentration now. The sooner the better this one's over. It. Eventually, Eric Tang levels the match. One game, one set apiece, 21-10 of the second. A little bit of a dull game compared to the first. It was so exciting and so tight. I think Eric has to be really aware that his opponent is going to come back out a different man in this third game. He will try and bring back that power game and. For the second half of that game, Lin was literally just trying to build up the reserves of energy again to come out fighting in this deciding set. Another change of shirt for the man from Chinese Taipei. He's gone to lime, green, and white. Of course, Eric Tang is so laid back, I don't think he sweats. Fourth one, 20 seconds. Okay. So Lin taking the full allotted time. Eric Tang already back out on court. In the next game that was being so kind to Eric, just let him down in the first 2 points of this deciding set. Over 1-2. Lots of errors at the moment from both men. Now is that big right arm. That shot is one of many points in this game. Yeah, good advanced position from Eric, up higher than that, ready for the attacking kill. Looks like the energy fuel tank is full again. Oh. Also in these men's singles matches, when they fall, they make sure to just lie down and get a good imprint on the court so they can take a rest. Yeah. Six five. Eric Pang with the 1 point advantage in this deciding game. This men's singles semi final. Very poor serve. Lazy error. And these breaks that Lin is taking sometimes is affecting the concentration of Eric. You can see it. Oh, minutes gone by. 3/4 of an hour in this match. Well, wide, long way wide.
9-8.
Oh, ho, ho. Retrieving the shuttle, it was so far behind him, I don't know how he got his racket around it. But somehow he did. I don't think Lin expected it to come back.
Yeah.
A lucky block. Strong in defense, Eric. Yeah, playing the net. Good net. Yes. A great example of turning strong defense into attack.
11-9,
interval. Good one from Eric Pang. It's the interval lead, 2-point lead. Both men starting to lift their level again towards the end of this match.
Okay, stay on court.
And we're back in a quick point for Lin. I wouldn't call it a problem, but this is a feature of Eric in every match I've ever seen him play. I think Eric would prefer if there were no intervals, because he does lose the concentration. And he's like a diesel engine, just takes a little bit of time to get going again. Yeah. No. Yeah, and then it wins a point, and then it's back on again. Good aggressive return and serve. Took it nice and high, nice and early. Quick point. Of course, the women's singles is already an all-Asian final. As Europeans, we could really do with Eric Tang winning this match. That's better from Eric. Four in a row. Mentally back in the game after the interval break. Oh.
17-12.
Such a lovely stroke at the net. Yeah, I think the fuel tank is empty again. Yeah. Not only energy, but the mental fuel tank. Ooh! I've no idea what age he is.
13.
Lin.
18.
Yeah. I think this point is a huge point. If Eric gets to 19, I think it's almost game over. Yeah. Oh yeah. I think Lin expected it back out wide. Pang going down the forehand side. Yeah, 19-13. All the money on Eric. To advance to the final. And then sort of a lazy serve again. 14-19. His accuracy out wide on those smashes is almost pinging on the line. And with that, it's match points for Eric Pang. Yeah, that's it. Dutchman Eric Pang through to the final. Good game, good control game from Eric. Mentally strong, tactically very strong. And Eric Pang who goes through to tomorrow's final. My thanks again to Linda. Thank you. And we'll be back shortly with an interview with Eric, followed by Mental Language Mills against Boss and Ritter.
Lot of soul.
Eric, good to see you the first time this week, and first match, three-set battle. But do you think mentally you were sort of the stronger of the two players there?
Yes, I was very happy with this win. I was a little bit unfortunate to lose the first game. I had some chances there, and maybe a couple of months back I would have lost the match, but now I kept believing in the win, and I pulled it off.
In the second, he seemed to run out of gas. Did you notice that
energy-wise and mentally, he just seemed to lose the power. He had a lot of matches coming through qualification this week. So was it a question of keeping him in from long rally?
Yeah, I try to keep him from his matches. He's a hard smash. If I got those shots back, then he had difficulties making the points, and he was getting impatient. I felt so, that worked very good.
And your net play, you must be happy with the way that circle just thrown over the net on so many occasions for winning.
I don't know about that.
It's good, yeah, they were watching you up and going, ooh, and ah. But anyway, you're through to the final. You play Andre Tejono tomorrow. How do you see that one? Have you played him much before?
Yeah, I played him, I think, three times, and I think I lost all of them. So, I hope to do better tomorrow.
He's the defending champion, and good time of year. It's generally a good time of year for you. You're coming to the Dutch Open shortly. You've won that in recent past. So, beginning of the season is always a good time for you.
Yeah, I like to play. I've prepared well, and I always like to play close to home. I have some support. So, I'm looking forward to the final.
You're hoping for the Belgians to be behind you tomorrow?
Yes. I need help the support. Yeah.
I'm sure there'll be a big call here tomorrow. Thank you for joining us. Very well.
Thank you.